Right, we're back from war. Let's go. There, see, like there's an easy hand to fold. 10-2 on the buttons, an easy fold. The other wee hand, let's shoot connectors. Any two over. Right, this is good. We're getting to this is the stage. I actually play a short stack. Really good, I think. I actually play a short stack better than I play a big stack, truth be told, which is actually true. So let's count up here. We'll do it next hand. We'll see just that what our aim is, just out of interest. I know we're a long way off that, really. But we're getting shovels. And remember, it's effective stacks, not actually our stack. So effective stacks, make sure we take a note of that. In fact, I'll just make a note of that quickly. Right, we're back. Right, before we begin this hand, I remember rule of 10, 5, etc. Definitely coming in with a raise here. Maybe what, 5, 5, 5 would go as good. Three raises, I would fold. Oh, yeah, right, okay, as I said, a passive to nothing wrong with that. Right, I tend to, I actually forget to limp small pairs sometimes. And I think actually I don't th I think that's actually okay to one. Now I always say if the hand's not good enough to raise, blah, blah, blah. But if the table's not raising and re-raising, sometimes I don't mind it. And I actually maybe lately, well up until lately, I probably would limp 1 in 100 hands. But lately, when I've been reading over my old books again, I don't know if it's very 2007. I don't know, but. I've started to limp, maybe in situations. Like, no, I don't know, but I would always come in with a raise there. Really, with this your stack, etc. But anyhow, nothing wrong. Let's see. Right, so there. Right, that's the problem. And again, you're not getting there. Right, so he's raising. What's the most you can win here? The most you can win is doubling up. So the most you can win is 8,000. It's costing you 600. That's you have to fold there, Rick. If you double the stack and he double the stack, then fine. But look, he's on the button. He's just at it. If you'd have come in with a raise, you'd have been in control of the hand. You'd have been the one showing with the impetus type of thing. And that's why I would always come in with a raise because it probably could. It's cheaper in the long run because here, look, you're having to put 800 odd in. If you'd have raised, it'd only have been 555, which would have been fine because then you were getting like 20 to 1 to hit him. He's got 10,000, so 500. You're getting about 20 to 1. You're getting the right thing to set mine. Here, you have to actually just fold that, Rick. I'm afraid, but I've seen that you didn't. See, he's got position. He's got impetus. That's how you win. That's how you win, and that's how you dwindle away chips. We playing out of position, calling raises out of position, and I'm not slag the limp, but I so I was a fold. What's he doing? Donkler, donkler. Right. Like it, nice. Actually, just going back to that hand quickly. In fact, this hand might have been a better example. There, that is actually, it's not a good hand, but see about here, if you had Jack, nine, whatever, anything at all, and actually, see when I'm talking about this raise folding, the important thing is. As you don't want short stacks behind you that are going to just ship you. So that's an important thing with that raise folding thing. If everyone's all sitting with 20 big blinds or more, then yep, raise folding is brilliant, works well. But you see there, you've got a guy with, I don't know, 15 big blinds or something. So raise folding doesn't work quite as well when you've got short stacks. Well, it doesn't work at all. You just don't do it with short stacks behind you. So remember, raise folding with sort of less than great holdings is a good thing, but don't do it with short stacks behind them. I'm having a go at myself more than anything there. Right there, again, aye, that's what we put onto it. See, if that guy had more, I don't think there's anything wrong with even there doing a wee steal. But now you don't have the chips for that. In fact, how much is your 575 in? So you're only playing with, don't know, 15 big eyes. Really, you're played for all your chips next hand. We'll slow this down. Right, okay, right, before we go here, similar thing to what we've been saying previous. You're playing out of position. In fact, even queens in position, it's always a re-raise anyhow. It's different from aces, where you can just call and trap. But with queens, I mean, any king, any ace, the flop, you're fucked. So here, Rick, you need to just shove this, I hope. I hope you don't do anything else. Oh, well, actually, suddenly well, this is interesting, actually. You made it two, three times that guy's raises with aces, and you're actually making it quite a, that's what I would, well, that's a nice sizing. But you're doing that with queens, so a hand is actually worse. You're actually raising less with, so do you just raise more with bigger hands? To me, actually, the roles are reversed here because you're out of position and you've got queens, which is vulnerable to a flop. Here, you really just want to take that down. And look, you've put in most of your, well, a good percentage of your stack anyhow. To me, that's 100% just a sheer, just ship that. And the reason why you're just shipping it is because you've only got, you've got an M, you've only got, I don't know, 18 big blinds or something. Aye, 17 big blinds, you got less than 20 big blinds, just ship that. With aces, yep, you might have got, yep, I would have maybe done that, but you'd have looked awfully strong. But I just find it funny how earlier you've done it three times and then now in a position where you should be doing it more, you're actually doing it less. So that's quite interesting. And notes on him I would take. He would be raise two min raise stealing fold to things, so then you can start through doing the exact same bets with him with ace five suited and things like that. And so take notes on him. Know that he raises and he folds, he min raise folds. He's doing a lot of stealing, so that's when you start re three betting with hands that are not quite as good. Right, we'll race on a bit here. What's going on here? Again, Rick, you don't. It's not a great spot, 10s under the gun there, but you have to raise, Rick. You seriously, seriously have to raise there. And he does a small shove. And it plays itself down, but I think he certainly had to raise the thing there. I wouldn't be limping much under the gun there. He's a fool, isn't he? That's just terrible by him. I mean, pair of jacks, you don't want to do at the exact position that you get in. Oh, look, he's still at it as well. No, I never really looked too much at that, but it seemed okay. And again, you got a shorty stack behind you, so you're limited in what you can do. Is these short stacks? Sometimes I get my decimals mixed up. Now we're up the top now. Let's go back there. He calls, he calls, okay. Right, that's fine. That's calls. But I suppose it's calls. He should have raised. A lot of people like to limp the hands like King 9 and Queens 10. Small bit by bit. Nah, I would raise and get you out of that point before we even got to this. Oh, now he's just hit a nice check back. And you have to call the thing. Right, before we end here, you know what I'm going to say? You're playing out of position. So a call here would be, I'm not saying it's really bad, but it is actually pretty bad, right, if you call, because you just don't want to do it. Yeah, I know it's only 200, but you need to raise or you need to fold when you're out of position again, as I say. And if you're in position, you like to raise, but anyhow, I would fold there. I mean, ace comes the thing, ace jack stacks you, end of tournament, another back beats, well, another sad story to tell. Remember that in small blinds, Rick, just really, 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 you've really got to tighten up your small blind. You're going to limp, aren't you? Oh, no, I'm in range. I suppose you mix up your play. Okay, right. Yeah, nothing wrong with that. In fact, that is the play, I would say. C bet. Lovely. Oh, how big was that C bet? As he calls, 2,000 in the pot. Don't, so that, it's a horrible flop. Ah, you half pot it, I suppose. I just hope that no more. I thought that, Rick, too far, at least half again, too much. I remember 1,000 there would have done the same job as 1,500. I know that your reasoning probably was to look as if you're trying to protect against draws, but definitely that's 500, because you'd have to have folded if he'd have shoved. So that would have been 500 chips saved if the thing half pot it there. There's nothing wrong with it. No need to three quarter pot. Again there, see, right, let's have a look at the old race fold. So guy behind you, his thing, nah. Again, it doesn't work because there's too many shorties behind you. So nothing wrong with the fold. He keeps on limping, I think. Check. That's fair. I'm limping all the time. I would start re-raising him quite a bit myself, especially you got a rock there. I don't know about Dodger Rint, but well, nothing wrong with the fold, especially if you're just playing a conservative game. But if you really want to start getting taking these down, I think against guys like him, his limping's not the thing. But again, now I'm really fingering its straws with that one. That's not a major. Oh, the old pairs again, right? I think you have to raise with these, Rick. I don't. I think at this stage of the tournament, when you've got so many people that are going to reship on you, see under the gun there, that's an easy fold. Even there, threes is an easy fold at this stage of the tournament. But here, you definitely need to come in, knock it up to 850 or something. I think you are limping these far too. The reason why that I'm not liking it is because it's really exploitable. See somebody that's limping, so anyone can come over the top, and you have to fold. It's just so exploitable. And learning to play unexploitable. See, now that, what are you really representing there, Rick? You can't represent. I would put you all in no matter what there, because I mean, it's hard to represent anything that connects with that board, really, isn't it? And that's why. But if you'd raise pre-flop, you're the one. It's one of the most important things of poker is, well, bar position. It's actually being the taking the lead, as in you've raised. It's sure you've got a. You've already telling people, listen, I've got something here, and people are more likely to believe you now. And I hope he does come over the top and ship you. Oh, he played that bad, whatever he done. Well, I should tell, like, you limped, didn't you? Right, we're running out of time again. Should we come back for the jacks? No, let's go. We'll fit this in. I like it. I don't know about the C bet size there. We'll try and just see that quickly. 4,000 and make it 2,000, Rick, please. Not three again, your C bets are too big, right? But it's good that you're doing them.